Hello, and welcome to Weather Watch, Millersville University's exclusive weather entertainment program. I'm your host, Ben Bonner. Last episode, Weather Watch's own Michael Yalsh looked into the topic of migration, but not all animals move to warmer climates for the winter. Some hang around in their natural environments and find other ways to survive. Student meteorologist Matthew Green has more on hibernation.
Fall is the season when many wild animals start to prepare for the cold winter months. As we learned last episode, some migrate to warmer climates, whereas others change their appearance to blend in with their environment. Let's now take a look at why some animals hide away and hibernate for the winter.
Before hibernation ensues, you talk about species that are, you know, hoarding food, or they're putting on a lot of fat. And groundhogs are unique because they'll hoard up a lot of food and they'll put on a lot of fat, and then they'll go into their burrow and they'll actually seal their burrows before they actually go into hibernation. And then they'll drop their body temperature down and they'll drop their activity rate down and even their metabolic rate down. And then they'll just cruise the rest of the winter, not waste any energy while they're in cold conditions. And the bats, the numerous bat species that occur in Pennsylvania, during their hibernation, they drop their body temperatures down really low, sometimes maybe around 40 degrees, 50 degrees Fahrenheit, which is pretty substantial. You know, you're going from something that's like 98 degrees when they're active and they're out and about, then something down to 50, maybe sometimes even lower. With them initially going into hibernation, the main indicator again, photoperiod, the amount of daylight. Once that amount of daylight changes, that starts sending signals. They're getting photoreceptor signals into the brain, and that brain then is sending signals to different hormone producers in the body, saying, okay, now this hormone is released or this hormone is suppressed, and so I'm going to start consuming more food, I'm going to start taking on more fat. And within the hibernators, it's a transitional thing. It's not like, oh, okay, today I'm just going to start to hibernate. It's a slow transition where they start picking up the activity of feeding more and preparing the burrow and maybe storing away food. And all of a sudden they start noticing there's a lot less food around. And then during that time when there's a lot less resources for them to consume, okay, now I'm gonna call it a season and I'm gonna go down and I'm gonna hibernate. All right, well, they're out of the sunlight. How do they know the days are getting longer? How do they know to wake up? And a lot of that has to do with the soil temperature. So the temperature around them, the ground temperature. Once the ground temperature starts increasing around them, that'll actually stimulate the groundhog or whatever hibernating species there is to start becoming aroused and start coming out of that hibernation. So as you move northward, the hibernation period for species that traditionally hibernate get longer and longer the higher the latitude you go.
As we see all around us, with a changing of the leaves and with decreasing temperatures, fall is a time of transition. Many wild animals are doing just that so they can survive the winter, whether it may be migrating, changing their camouflage, or hibernating. These changes truly mean life or death for these animals. Reporting for Weather Watch, I'm student meteorologist Matthew Green.
Thanks, Matt. Well, that's all we have for this episode of Weather Watch. Please be sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter at the addresses shown below. For those of you at home, thanks for watching. Be sure to tune in next time.